time in every young princess's life when she just needs, not wants, needs a supercharger. This is a really cool little supercharger. It looks just like a one that you'd see on a muscle car. It's like a Roots style blower. It's just miniature. In the description, it said it was made for like a 400 to 1000 cc engine or something like that, which we fall into that category. The hardest part's just gonna be driving it, because it's, you know, belt driven. We need an accessory belt just coming off the engine somewhere. Unfortunately, we can't really pull it off of the crankshaft, which would be ideal, because none of the access to it is accessible, for lack of a better word. It's all underneath the body here, behind the shocks and stuff. The first step is driving the supercharger. So I've got the valve cover off, and my plan is basically just to make an extension of the camshaft that drives a serpentine pulley, like so, to drive the supercharger. This camshaft is completely hollow. So what I can do, and it's, of course it's got two very solid bearings holding it on here. What I might do is just machine a shaft that fits nice and snug inside there, and then make a plate that bolts on with the cam bolts on that shaft that holds it nice and sturdy, and then just run the pulley on the outside of that as close as I can get it to the surface of the valve cover. And then of course I'll need some sort of a seal to keep it from leaking oil.
Take a quick break to talk about the sponsor of this video, Dazzle Pro, and the coolest toothbrush I've ever used, the Elements Sonic Toothbrush with a UV sanitizing base. Now this is just the coolest. After you're done brushing, you can throw it on the charger and put your head in this cabinet, and it's gonna have a UV light that kills 99.9% of the bacteria. I've been using this Dazzle Pro toothbrush for a while now, and I absolutely love it. And it's great knowing that every time I put on that brush head, it's clean. It has a 2-minute smart timer, so I know I'm brushing my teeth long enough. It's got 4 different modes. That's really nice. And this thing works for 6 weeks on a single charge. It's great. And Dazzle Pro is giving you guys early access to their Black Friday deal. It's 50% off. So check the link in the description, check this thing out, and then let's get back to building.
Here's the supercharger pulley drive shaft. So I made it on the lathe out of a solid chunk of aluminum because aluminum is easier to work with and lighter weight, and it should be plenty strong. I wasn't able to test fit it because it was in the lathe on this end, but using the calipers, I got it so snug that it's airtight. You can see the springiness of the air in there. So I think that'll do the trick. Well, a bit of lathe work and drilling, and I've got my clamp plate complete with speed holes. You can see it's got this slot in the back that lines up with this. Fits on there nice and perfect, and then clamps it all on there.
This probably isn't something that's super common to do.
Yeah, take a step drill to the side of your valve cover. This hole does not have to be precise at all. It just has to fit over the shaft because I'll make a plate later that bolts on and holds the seal, because there's just not enough material here to get the seal in this. So to bolt my seal holder flange onto here, I need to grind this logo off of there. And a perfect excuse to show off the new Ameribraid Fastback Belt Grinder that you can win by, you know, checking out our merch and entering to win. That was awkward and stupid, but you know what? We're gonna roll with it. Just getting every last drop out of this little piece of aluminum that we got at the scrapyard months ago. And now I'm gonna use it to make the plate that holds the seal for the shaft there to keep the oil inside the engine.
Coming together like clockwork.
Yeah, I think it's coming together quite nice.
Here's the seal holder plate and seal. We'll just go right like that. And then I left the seal sticking out the back just a little bit. So that'll get squished against the case here and seal extra around there. And then of course, I'll drill these holes and just tap them. They don't need to have a whole lot of force on them. They just need to hold the plate on there, so the thread's just through the magnesium case here. Should be fine, and then we'll just put a nice bead of RTV on there to seal the bolts themselves. And then we can throw the card back on and start it up and see what it looks like with it spinning that pulley. Idea whether that's a lot or a little. It seems pretty slow to me, and which makes sense because this is running off the cam, which spins at half the RPM of the crank. So we may end up needing to change out these sprockets or these pulleys
and put a larger one here so that we get more RPM on this one. I doubt we could get a smaller one than what's on here, but if we put a larger one on this end, it should work. I want to see what it'd look like going faster. I found this pulley in the pile of random gears and pulleys. It's just got the wrong size hole and it's splined, so I'm going to drill it out to this size, but I was looking at it and it is exactly twice the diameter. So, twice the speed.
That's so steampunk. We should do a steampunk build.
We really should.
Dang!
I love how well Sandy runs these days.
That looks so cool. I really hope this is the one we end up using. Heck yeah.
I will start with that one.
Yeah.
It's not really grindhard style to start with not enough. I think starting with too much is more. Bjorn agrees. Right, Bjorn?
Yep.
Too much, right?
Bjorn says more boost.
Yep, you heard him. Dog said more boost. That's perfect. And it's so much better too because it's actually way closer to the engine case, which means that the force of the belt pulling on it has far less leverage on the shaft, so it's sturdier, which is a good thing.